92 City FM. From Night Moves Cabaret at the Windsor Park Inn, this is 92 City FM's Friday Night Live. Broadcast in association with the Winnipeg Sun on 92 City FM.
Live welcome for Gemini on 92 City FM.
Yeah.
gotta get down here. It's a solo Gemini Originals. We're gonna do the cover stuff later, people, because we seem to be getting a few requests for like Ozzy and AC/DC and things like that. So we'll do that stuff later, all right? This whole set is dedicated to Gemini music. Right now, we're gonna slip into another one. This is brand new. It's not on our album. It's brand new. This is called Rock Hard.
Sky.
Friday night. Everybody out there in Radio Land, you got to get down tonight, Moose, and rock out with Gemini. Yes, the album is available here. You got to talk to our sound man after the set. He'll set you up. We got a whole bunch of other paraphernalia like shirts, t-shirts, sweatshirts, jerseys, schedules, posters, pictures, you name it, we got it. Just talk to Bob. He'll set you up. Are you ready for some more Gemini rock and roll? Say yeah! Good deal. This is the first song on the album. It's Lonely. Lonely! Steve, let me see these people. Yeah, put your drinks up in the air out there, people. We're going to do a Gemini booze whale. It's very simple. You put your drink in the air, and then I count to three, and you yodel the word booze. It's a party salute thing, all right? Are you ready to do it? Put them up. One, two, three. Boy, what a bunch of partiers. Stick those in your face, suck them down hard, order a little, tip your bartenders and waitresses. We got something that's gonna bring it down a bit here. This is kind of a power ballad type thing. So if you wanna get close to somebody that you know or somebody that you'd like to know better, do it. This is Coming Home.
Come on.
from Night Moves Cabaret at the Windsor Park Inn. This is 92 City FM's Friday Night Live. Broadcast in association with the Winnipeg Sun on 92 City FM.
All right, we are broadcasting live down from Night Moves Cabaret in the Windsor Park Inn. My name is Delaney, John Delaney, and I'm here with Lance of the band Gemini. Hell of a set, guys.
Thanks, John.
Very nice. And all original. Nice to hear that, too.
Well, thank you very much. It didn't surprise or anything, did it?
No, actually, I thought it was most applicable when you're live on the radio. It's kind of best to sell yourself, don't you think?
That's what I figured. Exactly.
Now, when you're playing venues, you guys are from Minneapolis, so in the States, do you find that the States are a little more open to receiving original music, or are you guys doing a lot of cover material down there as well?
We do the same thing, basically. We do about 50-50, and whenever we get a chance to do all originals, we do it.
Yeah, I guess so. Indeed. The originals we heard, I guess we heard about a 10-song set. Would that be right?
Yeah, I think so. Wait a minute. It was like 12.
12 songs? 12. Okay. How many do you guys have in your catalog of
originals? Right now, we've got about 16, and we're just working on the second album here.
You're pursuing the Elusive record deal, or is there something in the wind right now?
Oh, we got an album out on our own label, Nightmare Records, and
an independent deal.
Independent deal, sure. That's right. And we're working on drying. I think what we're going to do is demo the second thing with the three strongest songs and see if we can get some major label interest or minor label. I mean, minor label probably is better.
Okay.
In a lot of situations because you don't get lost in the shuffle.
You don't get lost in the shuffle. A little more time spent on the promotion of
right.
the band, sure.
If it doesn't happen, we'll do it ourselves again.
Sure, I hear you. How long ago did you release the independent?
A year and a half ago.
Okay, now. Some of the tunes that we heard tonight, I take it we're on that, or
probably half of them.
Half of them. Okay, now when you've got an independent, did you do it on CD or did you do it on a cassette or?
Did it on both.
On both, yeah. CD and cassette. Do you mind me asking how many printings you did? What, about 500 CD or?
We did 1,500 CDs and we did about 4,000 tapes.
My, what a bold venture!
Yes. Well, they sold like hotcakes.
Did they? Yeah. They moved pretty big. Well, the sound is real cool. I don't like to pigeonhole things, and I think most bands don't like to have somebody stand there and say, oh, I think you sound like this, so I'm not going to do that, but there is...
Don't!
There's some influences there that I think are readily available, but the band certainly seems to be turning it around onto their own sound. When you're writing tunes, what's the process? Is it a complete band effort, or is one person in the band a little more responsible for the writing?
Usually, the guitar player, Rob, comes up with the stuff right now, music-wise, and then we put it together and add in ideas musically, and then I take it and I'll put a lyric to it.
So it's you're writing most of the lyrics, he's writing the music
right.
as a general whole.
Yep.
Now the guitar player, is this the one with the Les Pauls?
That's right.
Guitar Meister General. What an amazing guitar player.
Well, that's good. Yeah, we got two good guitar players, two real good guitar players.
Oh, I mean, they're both very good, but I mean, his technique is unbelievable. I mean, he's got like a hammer on that really can't be beat. I mean, I've never seen fingers curved quite like that before, but that was very impressive.
Well, you know, he's crippled. No.
Yeah. It's actually a spasm thing, you know?
Yeah, that's it.
And he's turned it into... So, I also noticed that he's got a Kaler bridge on there with the old whammy bar on it.
No Kalers. No, it's. I think he only uses Floyds.
Oh, really? Okay,
yeah.
Right.
The only reason
I say Kaler is because they're about the only one that
Kaler.
I only thought they were the only ones that customized for Les Pauls as far as a whammy bar.
I don't think so. Is that Jerry? What do you think on that? Why don't you pick up a mic there, Jerry? He's just
sure. We got a mic here for you. There you go. Oh, that one's not plugged in. Don't worry, Jerry. It's handled, buddy. We'll take care of it for you.
You're talking to the wrong guy when it comes to guitars. I'm just a singer.
Jerry, what's the deal with that customized guitar setup?
He does all of his own work, actually. So he put the Floyd on it himself. And he painted them himself, too.
So a Floyd Rosen whammy bar and...
Rob
and
Kruger custom.
a total custom accent. Now, you're the other guitar player as well. What are you using? Is that a Kramer guitar? Or?
No, it's a Jackson.
What?
A Jackson.
Oh, yeah, Jackson, sort of a same kind of look to them. You're getting a great guitar sound. Is that your Marshall stack on the one side?
Yeah, we have all of our Marshalls modded by a guy in Faribault,
Minnesota.
Home
of nothingness, but
wait a minute.
But
now,
it's got
Faribault,
a great...
Minnesota, isn't that where the Maharishi's got a university or something down around there? No, that's Fairfield, Iowa. I'm sorry. That's right, yeah. But, you know, I was close. Anyway, so...
And there's Mr. Brian Reidinger, our drummer.
Wow, so everybody's down here. Hi, Brian, how you doing?
I'm doing marginally well at this moment.
Now, what would put you sort of over the top, Brian? What would make you feel a lot better than just marginal?
A new drum head, thank you.
Okay, well, that can certainly bring any drummer to a brand new light.
Well, we could have all your listeners send in some money.
So send your dollars to Gemini. What's the address, guys? Okay, now
you're doing a lot. Cabaret.
Now you do a lot of covers in the other sets, but a lot of original here. Is it as difficult as everybody has heard to get the record deal? Are you banging a lot of doors? Do you find a sense of frustration with the band, or is it, you know, like, because you guys believe in the product as much as you do, is it a little easier to take?
I think it's never an easy process. I mean, it's always continuing on. I mean, at least the ladder is in an upward motion continually, sure. So we're not sliding down. Things keep building. I just anticipate by the time. I think this one's going to go. I think this one's going to go because I feel really strongly about the material. I feel really strongly about the band.
Has the band gone through lineup changes?
Well, we did a couple of lineup changes, and it really made the difference. And I think that the people before, actually, we'd heard a few critiques from the labels that basically said we needed to do those changes. So
who did you replace?
Pardon me?
Who did you replace?
We replaced the drummer and the guitar player.
Right, yeah. But, so now this is the guitarist that was staying right there. He's the new replacement?
Yeah, he's the new guitar player.
Settling in very nicely. He got a chance to solo as well. The other guitar player playing the predominant solos, but it was nice to see him get a chance to cut loose a bit.
The other guitar player learned most of the stuff. A lot of this stuff that the other guitar player precedingly had written. So it's like he's, who knows? I mean, I don't know what the guitar player is
doing. I'm not even sure what line of direction this question is going, but you know. One thing I was going to notice is bands from America, and you guys are from Minneapolis, tend to focus a lot on the image as well as the music, whereas you might see in Canada where the bands are spending a lot of time on the music and don't kind of go for the image. You guys definitely all very coordinated, you know, I mean, kind of... without sounding kind of goofy or whatever, but the band is very image conscious. Is that something that is a prerequisite with you guys, or is it more something that just is very natural for you?
I think it's kind of natural, and it is kind of it was kind of planned too. I mean, we kind of had a look that we were going after. We at first, you know, we went with sort of a medieval vibe, and you know, it's kind of evolved into whateverness. You know, and I still stick with kind of a compilation of medieval meets contemporary metal, you know, and
sure,
it's just kind of...
Have you had any voice training? Because you've got an incredible range. I mean, you must be looking at like 2.5-3 octave range, eh?
Four octave range,
way up there, right?
It's just self-taught. I've been singing for about 13 years, and it's just, you know...
Well, 13 years is bound to, you know, sort of shape a voice, I'd
been
say.
On the road for about 7.5 to 8 years, somewhere in there, and it evolves, you know.
Yeah, you bet.
It sucked at first, and it's getting there, you know. It can
Isn't
always
that
get
always
better.
The way, though, they always go, you know, you guys are really great, but lose the singer. And then after a while, you start to develop a voice. And now here's that guitar maestro general.
Yeah, there's the guitar maestro general.
I just have to take a few moments out of some glorious praise, but you sound great, man. You got a great guitar sound and great technique. Now, do you work on it all the time?
All the time.
I can imagine. Both you guys, it's nice to have a player that you can trade off with.
It helps a lot.
It's
Spainy. I don't drink.
Get that drink out of his face. He's got a mic there.
Get this mic out of his face. He's one of those elusive guitar players, right?
He's one of those guys who doesn't like to talk very much.
Just lets his he gets a little nervous his playing. Now. Sure. Yeah. No, I can understand it.
Tubes world.
So what's next for Gemini? What do you guys got on the plate?
On the plate? Well, the plate is full of covers coming up because we played most of our originals. We've got a few that we didn't play, and we may even play some of the ones that we played. So those people out there that just heard it once and have never heard it before can come down and perhaps catch it again.
Right on. Where are you guys heading after this?
We're going back to the States, to Minneapolis for a week. We'll be at Sensations the week following. Not this weekend coming up, but the following weekend on Thursday through Saturday. So if anybody wants to go stateside, come on down to Grand Forks.
Cool. And the one last thing I want to ask you is... We were a bit elusive as far as pinning down what's happening for a record deal.
Unsure.
Yeah. Is there some interest being generated?
There's been interest since the last thing. It's they kind of said, wow, that's what you did your first thing. We'll wait around for the second when you get some shit straight. And oop, ha, some stuff straight.
Well done. Nice cover. Chris, I hope you got that beep sound in there. Yeah, probably not. Well, thanks very much, Lance. It's been great talking to you.
Thank you.
And best of luck with the band.
Thank you.
Very nice talking with all you guys.
Hello.
Best of luck, and hope to see you guys come through town again.